I'm Devin Murray, president of Gulf States Financial, and this is Better Together. This week's question comes from Brett Downs, an agent in Auburn, Alabama at Berkshire Hathaway Home Services. Brett asks the following question. What can an agent do to improve the efficiency of the buyer's financing process from start to finish? Excellent question. The selling agent's fundamental problem is you don't get to choose the house, the lender, or the appraiser, right? The appraiser's chosen by the lender. It's ordered from an AMC. It's random. Or is it? We're going to talk a lot more about that. This is really a timeless question. It deserves a lot more attention, and we're definitely going to give it that with some extra videos so that agents just like you, Brett, and all of you out there, no matter where you are, you can sharpen your skills on what's going on and what's happening in an immediate sense and be better serve your customers. So three things I would say. Ultimately, set the buyer's expectations about the lending experience and refer those that match that, okay? Vetted professionals, lending professionals. So number one, if your client has a certain expectation, maybe they have already chosen a lender and haven't heard of anything about what that might look like. And I'll talk more about that in just a moment. So main idea here is don't wait until the pre-approval, right? I know that there's a lot of different circumstances. There's no perfect world, right? You don't want to push your client. That's not what we're talking about. This is reaching out and establishing a line of communication. And so ultimately you don't want to wait. As your agent, I would not wait on a pre-approval to have a conversation. That is the main idea. And so ultimately, how do you establish that line of communication and what do you say? Now, to keep it simple, you're going to tell your customer that you're reaching out to them. You're going to ask for their contact information and tell them that you're going to call. Like, have your customer reach out and say, hey, this is who it is. This is my agent. They're going to be reaching out to you. They just want to have a couple quick questions before pre-approval, before we write this. Okay. So ultimately, number one is, and what we hear all the time, and I'm looking here at the email, is what communication method? What can I expect of you as the lender and loan officer about communication? So here's what I'm going to say. Am I going to get emails? Am I going to get phone calls or text messages? Do you have an automated system that's going to update us that's maybe not so necessary? When am I going to get those updates? What milestones are those? Those kinds of things, what stages? So that is super important for you. So you're not sitting around going, man, you're chasing the lender around. Let them tell you and then, you know, let them respond. So next question, huge question related to the market, basically to markets, no matter where you are, is this: what is your standard turn time? Ask that question. If their answer is 30 days, I don't think that's a cause for concern. And here's what I mean. In multiple offer situations and offer situations, multiple offer situations with cash, right? Your client who has financing needs the biggest advantage, right, over other offers. And by the way, I'm not just talking about the highest price, but what we're saying here is this: they need speed. And with speed comes accuracy with the lender. And so ultimately, what I kind of aim for, and we have some practices in place, but I like to tell the agent 25 days. Now, 21 to 25 days. Our goal is actually even shorter than that. So we'll unpack what that looks like later on in another series, but ultimately is that turn time, your client needs that advantage. And so if you don't hear that, we'll talk more about some other questions about that in just a moment. So another question, and this is, right, you're trying to establish a line of communication and you're trying to make sure this person has some idea of what they're doing, right? Fundamentally, I would suggest asking this question: have you or your firm done transactions in our local area recently? Meaning they're not local, right? Being local doesn't equal competence. I think everyone, if you just think about that for a moment, could agree. Now, that doesn't mean because the guy's not local or gal, right, loan officer, that, oh no, we've got to use a local person. I hear that, but there's some other strategies that I'll get into later in a later video that relate to that. And so the underlying question that you're really asking, right, is, and you're trying to be professional and you want to build a line of communication, is what are you doing? And are you sending an appraiser from three counties away to do this appraisal? Doesn't know anything, right? The big retailer situation. We hear it all the time, all over multiple states from everywhere, right? They have branches everywhere, but the appraiser drives from 100 miles away. You know, those are some of the questions you're asking. And so we're going to delve into that later, but let's talk about the appraisal. so we can kind of hammer on this, right? I would ask this question of every LO that you ever speak to is, do you do appraisal waivers? That speaks to the speed. We'll get into what that means later. Let them respond. Let them convince you and tell you all about it. Next question is, would you consider a rush? Now, if there's an appraisal waiver, if they do them, great. And let them explain how that works. But ultimately is, if you're telling me you can't close a deal in 30 days, here's the thing. Speed, bad news, fast is it gives you time to react. It gives you time to recalculate and have conversations to do what you need to do. But if a lender's telling you that they're going to turn around a loan approval to application to clear to close in 30 days, well, again, that's the old method. Can we get that appraiser faster so we can sort of clear that hurdle? Even if you've checked it, even if the buyer's waiving that, right? Doesn't matter. Like, it still has to happen for the loan unless you have an appraisal waiver, and you don't have to have that. So, and then the next question, I know this is a little deeper level, is does the AMC have a guaranteed turn time? And so we'll talk more about that later. The top lender should have equal access to appraisal management companies all over the place. And that includes brokers, that includes local guys. And if whomever that your customer's talking to, or whoever you're talking to, if, you know, I know that's a deeper level question, but they should have access to a lot, to the same. It is a level playing field and things are changing there. More on that later. So you've had a conversation with the LO. I would encourage this, use your influence in a professional way. Tell your buyer when you speak to LO, reinforce their choice. If you had a pretty good conversation, you feel pretty good about it, let them know. If you have concerns, don't make it personal. This isn't your guy, okay? The lender quoted me 30 days. He didn't know turn times. He said that there's no need for a rush. All of this sort of starts to paint a picture of like, this is really not good enough for my client. And you should set the bar high. If you're going to provide a high level of service and you don't want to write 10 offers, you need this competitive advantage. So it isn't steering. It isn't meddling. It is uncomfortable, but it's due diligence. And so with that being said, that's really the foundation, the start of it, right? So Brett, thank you for your question. I'm going to put Brett's comment, Brett's information in the section below, in the comment section below. And he's a great hustler in this particular market, in Auburn, Opelika market. If you want to know how other pros are crushing it, I'm going to ask you to hit that like and subscribe button here on the YouTube channel. But also more importantly is send us your questions, send us your scenarios, to questions at Gulf States Financial. You don't have to give us a bunch of information, but tell us what are your pain points. We'll give you a shout out in the comments. Make it a great rest of your week, and we'll see you next time on Better Together. Thanks so much.